नॉर्मल डेज आर इनफैक्ट वेरी वेरी बोरिंग. दीज आर वेरी स्पेशल डेज वेयर यू आर बीइंग इनवाइटेड टू सच अ ग्रेट कॉलेज विद सच ग्रेट एनर्जी एंड दिस वीडियो. इनफैक्ट स्पेशली हू हैज डन दिस वीडियो, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर देम. यू नो सच अ शॉर्ट टाइम. सॉरी, ओके, बाय द स्टूडेंट्स. सो थैंक यू प्रीति फॉर इन्वाइटिंग मी टू योर कॉलेज. थैंक यू टू द प्रिंसिपल, थैंक यू टू ट्रस्टीज, थैंक यू एवरी वन हियर. आई मीन आई कैन कम टू एनी कॉलेज इफ द फ्री टिकट्स आर देयर, एटलीस्ट एज फार एज आई मीन इन्वाइटेड टू माई होम टाउन. टू थिंग्स आई एम वेरी वेरी स्केयर्ड ऑफ, फर्स्ट इज फिल्म नरेशंस एंड सेकेंडली दिस स्पीचेस. एस्पेशली द स्पॉटलाइट इज ऑन यू एंड आई गॉट टॉक फॉर अ वेरी वेरी लॉन्ग, इट इज क्वाइट स्केरी. बट ठीक है, ऑल्सो द ब्रीफ इज दैट कि अब लाइफ में कुछ किया ना किया है, कितना उखड़ा पता नहीं, पर एटलीस्ट यू हैव टू शो दैट यू हैव डन अ लॉट, एस्पेशली इफ यू आर गिवन अ हॉस्पिटैलिटी एंड यू हैव फ्लोन, स्पेशली यू नो फ्लोन फ्रॉम बॉम्बे इवन मोर. बट आई हैव हर्ड दैट दिस इज इंडक्शन प्रोग्राम एंड स्टूडेंट्स हैव कम विद देयर पेरेंट्स, सो आई थिंक सो नाउ द ओनस इज ऑन देम ऑल्सो, टू द पेरेंट्स एंड टू द स्टूडेंट्स. So I think there's a lot of things we would like to cover today. I would like to talk about films, I would like to talk about regional films, I would like to talk about the process. I think this is where you are also probably starting your journey as academically into this field, and in fact you guys should feel very lucky. You have got such a great platform that the training to face the challenges which is going to come, whatever you do in media, whatever you choose, you start from day one. So you should absolutely, I mean, I don't think so, we were so privileged that we could come to or go to a college where I could absolutely connect with what I was studying, I could connect with my teachers, and to more of that, enjoy what probably I was doing. So I think these people have some set of questions, and what I want to say also probably will I think it can go hand in hand. So I think so we can start the Q&A.
Yes.
Okay.
Let's start the process.
Hi sir. First of all, thank you so much for taking time out and meeting us. I'm a film student, so you must have some idea how precious this might be for me. Let me start by
first question. I'm sure you see this coming. अभी तक कि मैंने जितने भी डायरेक्टर्स के इंटरव्यूज देखे हैं उसमें हमेशा हर डायरेक्टर के पास एवरीबडी हैज दिस स्वीट मोमेंट, यू नो, लाइक ये टाइम पे मुझे पता चला कि मुझे फिल्म मेकर बनना है, लाइक दैट वन मोमेंट. वॉज देर अ मोमेंट लाइक दैट फॉर यू एवर?
आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ आर्टिस्ट, यू नो, आई कॉल माय सेल्फ आर्टिस्ट बिकॉज आवर लाइव्स आर लाइक पेंडुलम्स. There are some very good days, there are bad days, and as you said that itne kharab din bhi dekhe hain, kharab, I mean I wouldn't say kharab, but then there are times where you want to do something, you're trying to do something and you're not getting there. So in that process, in fact you almost forget the good moments because there aren't many, especially in the early days, and of course we're still struggling. But definitely I think National Award was definitely won that moment because there's a time where you also want to be accepted and also want to be pursued in a certain way. So that award, I think so, that stamp definitely helped to and it opened a lot of doors for me. People started taking me very, very seriously. Our job is to chase producers, so that chase, that running became little easier, you know. At least I got the first chance, I got the first entry into the door. After that, it's the game still continues, you know. You're only as good as your last project, you know. So yeah, that was my sweet moment,
the national award winning moment.
Yeah.
So we all have our mentors, we all have people that we idolize, we all have works that we idolize. You mentioned in one of your interviews that Alejandro Gonzalez's films are particularly interesting for you. Is there someone else, and what about his films that you find captivating or maybe inspired you?
So I think before I take this question, I need to ask, so how many parents are here? If parents can just raise their hand, I just want to know the ratio. Okay, so there are very few parents. And students? Most of them students. Okay. And I assume, of course, the first row is... okay. So, coming to that question, yes, I mean, we all have our inspiration stories, you know. That one person which probably, knowingly, unknowingly, you do follow, and you do follow that journey. I think it was 2008 or 9, and in my journey, it was not like that I had thought that I want to be a filmmaker. In fact, I decided to be a filmmaker on a very, very later stage of my life. And that's why I feel that you guys are so privileged that at least you are getting a chance to be in a campus where you are learning different subjects every day. You get these many years to decide what you're good at, and the training becomes on a very early stage. When I was doing engineering, probably I knew, it's very filmy story actually. We were in third year, I bunked my college as every day I used to do. I had went to watch Gulal, Anurag Kashyap's Gulal. And I had been following films. In fact, my film school was actually watching films in that 4 years. I never attended any classes. And I was to watch 3 films a day, of course, on pirated. And all those films, which probably I would have watched in a film school, because I didn't get a chance to go to film school, I watch all those films at home. And I watched some, 1,000, 2,000 films in those 4 or 5 years. And that was my film school. And out of all those films, I think so, these films of Anurag came, and there was something about them which was very, very different. And as they say that we all follow that one person. So I think in 2009, I had loved Gulal and I decided that I want to be a maker. Where, but of course, you're not very sure about it because life is not that easy. And for me, in fact, one of the sweet moments was that in 2014, when I directed my first film, Anurag Kashyap was the co-producer of my film. So that journey and I very genuinely feel that what you actually aspire, what you see and what you dream, if you're focused and sincere about it, I think so, there are very good chances that, you know, you will end up getting there.
Yes, sir. That reminds me of Quentin Tarantino, who said that I didn't go to film school, but I went to watch films. Absolutely. And I think that's the best school you can ever have.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So one question that I would ask over here. Filmmaking is about art and direction, but being a director, one needs to be a good manager also, because I look at it from the management perspective. So raising finance in the initial years when you are directing something, raising finance, how challenging it has been, because, you know, talking to producers, convincing them about your projects. So what has been your strategy and how you have been taking this forward?
So in fact, to take this question holistically, watching films and making films, they are very different aspects. I mean, what we watch on theater, of course, we might agree to the fact that most of the stuff which that comes to us or we watch is not even watchable. Even if we feel the same. But when you're making a film, now definitely academically also filmmaking is being taken very seriously. Now we have film schools and we have institutes which help to basically get to know that process faster. But I personally feel when you're making a film, it's a process of 2.5 years from the point you're actually pitching and writing till the point you get the film out. 90% of it is just management. The creativity is just 10%. It's the tip of the iceberg, you know. What people see eventually is the tip of the iceberg, but what goes behind, below the water, nobody gets to know. And that hustle of probably getting your first film, getting your first financer, getting your first producer, being able to complete your script. I know you guys are very young now. I mean, that process, if any of you decide to go into films, and not just feature films. Now we have advertisements, we have web series, we have now, in fact, social media content is also going to go on a very professional. It is, so we have those agencies. So you might end up not directly into film industry, but you might end up definitely producing films in different formats. So eventually you are going to touch that. And this institute gives you the platform of going into that direction. So that can be nothing better than that.
Yes, yes.
So I think this process of pitching films, you know, I think one is a creative process and one, as you said, the 90% is management process. Has it ever been annoying or irritating or frustrating for you? I know how ideas can be so personal and this is my creation. To pitch that and to make someone else understand that, has it ever been cumbersome, like, ye nahi hona chahiye par ho raha hai? Like, kabhi aisa laga hai ki film haath se chhoot rahi hai?
So in fact, it happens all the time because making a film and wanting to make a film, usse bahut farak hai. Film तो आप तब बनाते हो जब आपको फिल्म मिलती है. एंड व्हाई आई ऑलवेज सी दिस दैट फिल्म मेकिंग इन जनरल इट्स अ वेरी एक्सपेंसिव आर्ट फॉर्म. इट इज़ नॉट अ पेंटिंग. यू पेंटिंग यू आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट पेंटिंग इज इजी आर्ट फॉर्म. आई एम नॉट ट्राइंग टू जज दैट. व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज दैट व्हेन यू आर डूइंग अ पेंटिंग इट्स अ जॉब विच यू डू अलोन विद अ ब्रश. इफ यू डोंट लाइक अ पेंटिंग यू टेयर इट अपार्ट यू मेक वन मोर पेंटिंग. फिल्म्स इज अ वेरी एक्सपेंसिव आर्ट फॉर्म. There are around some 300-400 people holistically they come together to make a film. There is a cost attached to it and you can't tear a painting, you can't tear a movie if it's not done well or it's not made well. So there are consequences to it. So because it is such an expensive art form, probably the most expensive art form, there is a lot of responsibility that also comes. So that's why they say that get your initial films right, because if my first initial films don't get right, nobody's going to invest money on me. At the end of the day, I will need a producer to produce a film. Of course, now there are many ways of making indie films, but if you're aiming to make big budget films with big stars, there is no way, but you have, they need to work, you know. So that hustle of getting a financial producer, I think so, we go day in, day out on that. Yes. And that is going to be there, and that's our way of life, you know. Matlab a fun film gets over and the process for fetching the producer for the next starts. It's a vicious circle and we have to go through it.
So about finding a subject for your story, what is your process? Do you go through this extensive research? Like, humko assignment milte hain. Whenever I write about films, I feel this dishonest part of me screaming inside of me ki like ye galat hai ya jhoot hai. What do you do? How do you go all in while searching for a subject, or do you wait for it to come to you? Like, is it passive or active approach?
So, you know, actually, a Korean film called Parasite won an Oscar 2 years back. I was personally very happy. So Bong Joon-ho had said in one of his interviews that the most personal journey is the most interesting one. And this also we have realized on a very, very later part of our stage, that the most personal story, which are to me, probably has the larger potential of turning out to be good than something which is very generic, you know. Because in life, generic is very, very boring. I think so what's important these days is a perspective. Whatever you do, you're making a song, you're making a drawing, you're making a picture, you're doing a news story, politics ke upar bahut film bani hai. Mera perspective kya hai politics pe? That is very interesting. Environment pe bahut film bani hai. Like, I was glad to be part of India's entry to Oscars. There's a team which sends our entry to Oscars. So we were a team of 13 people in 2017, and we had many films that year. We had Dear Zindagi, Bahubali, and all those films. Of course, they were great films, but we knew that we can't send Bahubali to Oscars or Dear Zindagi to Oscars. So I think 13-14 din ka process hota hai, and hame aisi film mil nahi rahi thi. And every year we are being accused. Every jury member is accused that we don't send correct entries. The last time Hindi film got or Indian film got selected was Lagan in 2001. After that, there hasn't been any film which has got shortlisted into foreign film category in Oscars. So of course, there's a lot of pressure. So on the seventh day, we watched this film called Newton. And the moment we saw Newton, internally, we all knew the fact that this probably is entry which has a good potential to go. Also the fact that the world is very, very curious about how does the largest democratic country really function. And Newton had a very good exposition. इट हैड एक्सपोजिशन कि गिर के अंदर वोटिंग बूथ सिर्फ एक बंदे के लगता है, पर एक बंदा भी अगर वोट दे रहा है तो वोटिंग बूथ लगना चाहिए. एंड दैट इज प्रोबेबली वन ऑफ द मोस्ट अमेजिंग थिंग्स अबाउट आवर कंट्री, हाउ एक्चुअली द कंट्री हुज लार्जेस्ट डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री फंक्शंस. सो दैट स्टोरी वॉज वेरी वेरी पर्सनल. एंड एक्चुअली इफ यू सी द मोस्ट इंटरेस्टिंग फिल्म एंड द मोस्ट इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी विच हैज कम आउट, which are actually personal stories, and those stories actually has been occurred to the writers and directors themselves, to them. And that is the reason, because as they say that ki meri next film chalegi mujhe pata nahi hai, but when I'm making that film for an, at least I'm staying with that idea for an year, mujhe to achhi lage, agar mujhe hi pasand nahi aa rahi hai to audience ko pasand kaise aayegi. So yeah, though I think the stories has to be personal. In fact, not just in films but whatever you do.
So how do you foresee the urban Gujarati cinema? Because I can see that there is a transition from...
There are times where you want to do something and you are trying to do something and you are not getting there. So in that process, in fact, you almost forget the good moments because there aren't many, especially in the early days, and of course this is struggling. But definitely, I think National Award was definitely for that moment because it is a, there's a time where you also want to be accepted and also want to be pursued in a certain way. So that award, I think so, that stamp definitely helped to open a lot of doors for me. People started taking me very, very seriously. Our job is to chase producers. So that chase, that running became a little easier. You know, at least I got a first chance, I got a first entry into the door. After that, it's the game still continues, you know. You're only as good as your last project, you know. So yeah, that was my sweet moment.
National award winning.
Yeah.
So we all have our mentors, we all have people that we idolize, we all have works that we idolize. You mentioned in one of your interviews that Alejandro Gonzalez's films are particularly interesting for you. Is there someone else, and what about his films that you are, that you find captivating or maybe inspiring?
So, I think before I take this question, I need to ask, so how many parents are here? If parents can just raise their hand, I just want to know the ratio. Okay, there are few parents. And students? Most of them students. Okay. And I assume, of course, the first place. Okay. So, coming to that question, yes, I mean, we all have our inspiration stories, you know, that one person which probably knowingly, unknowingly, you do follow, and you do follow that journey. I think it was 2008 or 9, and in my journey, it was not like that I had thought that I wanted to be a filmmaker. In fact, I decided to be a filmmaker on a very, very later stage of my life. And that's why I feel that you guys are so privileged, that at least you are getting a chance to be in a campus where you are learning different subjects every day. You get these materials to decide what you are good at, and the training becomes on a very early stage. When I was doing engineering, well, I knew that's very good story actually. Even in third year, I won my college as every day I used to do. I had went to watch Gula, Kamala Kashyap Gula, and I had been following films. In fact, my film school was actually watching films only in like 4 years. I never had any classes. And I was to watch 3 films in a day, of course on pirating. And all those films which probably I would have watched in film school, because I didn't get a chance to go to film school, I watched all those films at home. And I watched about 1,000 films in those 4 or 5 years. And that was my film school. And out of all those films, I think so, these films of Anurag came, and there was something about them which was very, very different. And as this is that we all follow that one person. So I think in 2009, I had loved Kudal and I decided that I want to be a maker there. But of course, I'm not very sure about it, because life is not that easy. And for me, in fact, one of the big moment was that in 2014, when I directed my first film, Anurag Kashyap was the co-producer of the film. So that journey, I had a very genuine feeling that what you actually aspire and what you see and what you dream, if you are focused and sincere about it, I think so, there are very good chances that you will end up getting it.
Yes, sir. That reminds me of Quentin Tarantino, who said that I didn't go to film school, but I went to watch film.
Absolutely.
So I think that's the best school you can ever have.
Absolutely.
So one question that I will ask over here. Filmmaking is about art and direction, but being a director, one needs to be a good manager also, because I like to become a manager in person. So raising finance, in the initial year of your directing, so I'm raising finance, what challenging it has been, because we were talking to producers, convincing them about your project. So what has been your strategy for your film taking this forward?
So you can, to take this question, basically watching films and making films, they are very different aspects. I mean, what we watch on theatre, of course, we might agree to the fact that most of the stuff which that comes to us when we watch is not really watchable. Even if we feel the same. But when you're making a film, now definitely academically also filmmaking is being taken very seriously. Now we have film schools and we have institutes which help basically get to know that process faster. But I personally feel when you're making a film, it's a process of 2.5 years from the point which you're pitching and writing to the point you get the film out. 90% of it is just management. The creativity is just 10%. It's the tip of the iceberg. What we can see eventually is the tip of the iceberg, but what goes behind below the water, nobody gets to know. And that hustle of probably getting your first film, getting your first financer, getting your first producer, being able to complete your script. I know you guys are very young now. I mean, that process, if any of you decide to go into films and not just feature films. Now we have academic films, we have web series, we have now, in fact, social media content is also going to go on a very professional basis. So we have those agencies. So you might end up not directly into film industry, but you might end up definitely producing films in different formats. So eventually you are going to touch that. And this institute gives you the platform of going in that direction. So that can be nothing better than that.
Yes. So I think this process of pitching films, you know, I think one is a creative process and one, as you said, the 90% is management process. Has it ever been annoying or irritating or frustrating for you? I know how ideas can be so personal and this is my creation. To pitch that and to make someone else understand that, has it had been cumbersome, like, ये नहीं होना चाहिए पर हो रहा है कभी ऐसा लगा कि फिल्म हाथ से छूट रही है
सो इन फैक्ट इट हैपेंस ऑल द टाइम बिकॉज मेकिंग अ फिल्म एंड वांटिंग टू मेक अ फिल्म उसे बहुत फर्क है फिल्म तो आप तब बनाते हो जब आपको फिल्म मिलती है एंड व्हाई आई ऑलवेज से दिस दैट फिल्म मेकिंग इन जनरल इट्स अ वेरी एक्सपेंसिव आर्ट फॉर्म इट इज नॉट अ पेंटिंग पेंटिंग I am not saying that painting is easier, I am not trying to touch that. What I'm trying to say is that when you are doing a painting, it's a job which you do alone with a brush. If you don't like a painting, you tear it apart, you make up a painting. Films is a very expensive art form. There are around 300-400 people who realistically they come together to make a film. There is a cost attached to it. And you can't hear a painting, you can't hear a movie if it's not done well, it's not made well. So there are consequences to it. So because it is such an expensive art form, probably the most expensive art form, there is a lot of responsibility that also comes. So that's why they said that get your initial films right, because if my first initial films don't get right, nobody's going to invest money on me. At the end of the day, I need a producer to produce a film. Of course, now there are many ways of making indie films, but if you're aiming to make big budget films with big stars, there is no way but you have, you need to work. So, that hustle of getting a financial producer, I think so, it will be directly out of that. And that is going to be there, and that's our way of life. You know? A fun film gets over, and the process for fetching the producer for the next starts. It's a vicious cycle, right? We have to go through it.
So, about finding a subject for your story, what is your process? Do you go through this extensive research? Like, of course, I've been with them. Whenever I write about films, I feel this dishonest part of me screaming inside of me. Ki, like, गलत है, झूठ है, व्हाट डू यू डू, हाउ डू यू गो ऑल इन व्हाइल सर्चिंग फॉर समथिंग, और यू वेट फॉर इट टू कम टू यू, लाइक इज इट पैसिव और एक्टिव अप्रोच?
सो यू नो एक्चुअली अ कोरियन फिल्म कॉल्ड पैरासाइट वन ऑस्कर 2 इयर्स बैक, आई वाज पर्सनली वेरी हैप्पी. So, Bong Joon-ho said in one of his interviews that the most personal journey is the most interesting one. And this also we have realized on a very later part of our stage, that the most personal story which unto me probably has a larger potential of turning out to be good than something which is very generic to one. Because in life, generic is very, very boring. I think so. What's important these days, as a visual, is a perspective. Whatever you do, you're making a song, you're making a drawing, you're making a picture, you're making a news story. Politics is a powerful body. Mera perspective kya hai politics pe? That is very interesting. Environment is powerful body. Like I was glad to be part of India's entry to Oscars. There's a team which sends entry to Oscars. So we, I think we were a team of 13 people. On in 2017, and we had many films that year. We had Dear Zindagi, Bahubali, and all those films. Of course, they were great films, but we knew that we can't send Bahubali to Oscars or Dear Zindagi to Oscars. So I think 13-14 films ka process hota hai, and hamein se film milne hai. And every year we are being accused, every jury member is accused that we don't send that entries. The last time of Hindi film got or Indian film got selected was Zabaan in 2001. After that, there hasn't been any film which has got shortlisted into foreign film category in Oscars. So of course, there's a lot of pressure. On the seventh day, we watched this film called Newton. And the moment we saw Newton, internally we all knew the fact that this probably is an entry which has good potential to go. Also the fact that the world is very, very curious about how does the largest democratic country really function. And Newton had a very good exposition. It had exposition ki ghir ke andar voting booth sirf ek bande ke andar. Aur ek banda bhi agar vote de raha hai to voting booth lagna chahiye. And that is probably one of the most amazing things about our country, how actually the country whose largest democratic country functions. So that story was very, very personal. And actually, if you see the most interesting films and the most interesting stories which has come out, which are actually personal stories, and those stories actually has been occurred to the writer directors themselves, to them. And that is the reason, because I always said that my next film, Chalenge, mujhe pata nahi hai. But when I'm making that film, or at least I'm staying with the idea for a year, mujhe toh achhe lage, agar mujhe pasand nahi aa rahe, toh audience ko pasand kaise aayega. So yeah, but I think the stories has to be personal. In fact, not just in films, but whatever you do.
So how do you foresee the urban Gujarat cinema? Because I can see that there is a transition from rural Gujarat cinema right from the days of Dalish to the most important to the kind of films. And do we see people or do we see people in the Dalish way or the other movies? So I am happy about this transition. So how do you foresee about this transition of happening? Both the things you can handle.
So I mean, to look back my journey, I think in 2010
and 2011, when I completed my college, I met these two amazing guys, Abhishek Jain and Anisha, and we started this company. I think a lot of credit goes to Abhishek also. The idea of making KV Ritejesh happened there. And it was, I think, almost like a blue ocean strategy where you're trying to do something which is completely non-existent, you know. I mean, I remember when I told people when I came from Bombay back to Gujarat and the idea of making a Gujarati film, it sounded very stupid because people were not, at least the urban side and the western, they were not watching Gujarati films. But somewhere down the line, I think so things got clicked, and I think so with Kivirtiyesh, we were, at least we managed to get audiences to the theaters. Eventually, Bayar happened. So the idea with Bayar was that now to make a bigger and better film. And Bayar happened, and Bayar definitely gave a lot of confidence. It got a huge footfall. There was an audience who was ready to watch films. And in 2016, with Wrong Side Raju, the idea was not just to make a better film, but we want to make a different film. So trying to do a thriller that time in 2016 also was very scary, but hopefully it went well. And now, of course, we remember those films, but I don't know, the jury might have been different if those films wouldn't have worked. So yeah, that has been my brief journey with Gujarati films, minus the Hindi film which I did 2 years back.
So a lot of credit goes to you from, you know, having that transition from the single screen to the multiplexes, having crowd coming for watching these films, Gujarati cinema. So
जब मैं पर्सनल स्टोरीज की बात करी मेरे को तो आई डू फील देर इज अ लॉट ऑफ पोटेंशियल. आई एम पर्सनली हूँ एवी एक फिल्म माटे वेट करूँ छू जे गुजरात में बधा रेकॉर्ड्स तोड़ी नाखे. आई थिंक व्हाट सायरा डिड टू मराठी सिनेमा, आई थिंक वी आर स्टील वेटिंग फॉर दैट वन फिल्म. एंड आई एम वेरी जेन्युइनली फील that film will be directed from someone who is from a B town or a C town. That story, which probably we city people we don't know or we haven't come across, I very genuinely feel ki wo insaan ek bahut chote se gaon se hoga. I think what Nagaraj Manjule did with Sairat and completely changed, at least in recent times, about Marathi industry, I am praying that, and I'm very sure that the ones who know films or who talk about films very smartly, and they know that, they at least try to show that, it won't be among them. It is going to be by someone who probably comes from a most underprivileged background, but the voice would be very, very strong. And I think so, as an audience, we are interested to know that voice.
So about crowd not turning up
in theaters for films like say New Delhi, Zindagi, do you think a film as an art form, uski reachability, like crowd turning prospects, ya uski appealability uski aesthetics mein hoti hai? What do you strive for more, like crowd turning up or maybe making a good film that is satisfactory?
I think at the end of the day, kitne bhi aesthetics ki baat kar lo, what we have realized the fact that you can make a bad film out of a good script, but you can't make a good film out of a bad script. So at the end of the day, it is that script. And it also applies in life also. The when you have a manuscript in hand in whatever you do, a project or painting or anything you do, but if you have it solid on paper, there is no way it can go wrong. So I think so the fate of a film actually depends on if it is right on paper or not. So these factors of stars and music and aesthetics, they come on a very, very later stage. Of course, we all want to reach that sweet spot. I think so. This is the reason why we all love Raju Hirani films. We do love. How many of you are fans of Three Idiots? So Three Idiots, Lagero Munna Bhai, all these films were loved because it had a very correct intersection of aesthetic sensibilities, emotion and entertainment. And that's what I think so every maker is trying to do. We are working hard towards it, but it's as difficult to get a script right. It seems to be, but it's very difficult to get a script right. I mean, if it was so easy, then we all would be making blockbuster films. So, yeah, I think so. It's a script at the end of the day. That's what I believe.
The content, yeah. So ever since, I don't know if I should discuss this, ever since Kabir Singh and the controversy around it happened and the thesis that I'm right now working on, I am noticing this spur of this particular question of responsible art. Like, do you think any art form should be responsible, or maybe creators should be responsible for what they might try to change or not, what they convey to the society? Should they be held responsible for what we can call a figment of imagination of a person? Like, they are still human beings. I don't know. Yeah.
So talking about Kabir Singh, I'm not going to talk about Kabir Singh because then it's a long debate and it's a completely a session in itself. I think a lot has been spoken about Kabir Singh and discussed. How many of you have seen Kabir Singh? How many of you have liked Kabir Singh? Okay, interesting. At least they are honest about it. Okay, so I'll give you a very interesting perspective about what we actually like and what we કહેવાય ને કે શું એક્ચ્યુઅલી તમને ગમે છે અને તમે લોકોને શું બતાવો કે તમને શું ગમે છે. આઈ વિલ ગિવ યુ ઇન્ટરેસ્ટિંગ પર્સપેક્ટિવ. દેર વોઝ અ ફિલ્મ કોલ્ડ મુક્તિ ભવન. દેટ ફિલ્મ વોઝ બેસિક એક્ચ્યુઅલી અબાઉટ સિનિયર સિટીઝન્સ એન્ડ યુ નો. સો ફ્યુ યર્સ બેક એક થિયેટર હોલની અંદર એક સિનિયર સિટીઝન માટે શો રાખ્યો હતો અને ચાર સ્ક્રીન બુક કર્યા હતા અને બધાને મુક્તિભવન બતાવીએ. સો મુક્તિભવન સ્ટાર્ટ થઈ એન્ડ ઓલ 60-65 પ્લસ એજેડ પીપલ યુ નો. 15 મિનિટ પિક્ચર સ્ટાર્ટ થઈ બધા લોકો ગાયબ. પછી ખબર પડી કે ઇન્ટરવલ પછી કે એ લોકો બીજા સ્ક્રીનમાં ગયા હતા કેમ કે બીજી સ્ક્રીન પર ગ્રાન્ડ મસ્તી ચાલતી હતી. સો બધા લોકો ગ્રાન્ડ મસ્તી જોવા જતા રહ્યા. સો ધ મોસ્ટ ફનીસ્ટ ફેક્ટ અબાઉટ કબીર સિંગ ઇઝ દેટ ધ રીઝન વાય ઇટ હેઝ ગોટ 300 crores ઇઝ ઇટ્સ વોચ most of it is watched by actually mid-age women, and to all that has been spoken about that film, all the controversial part about misogyny, about everything, but the irony is that 70-80% of its traction has come from women and they have liked it. So this is very borderline discussion, you know, and it's going to be always a debate about what's wrong and what creative. But I do feel that as a creator or as creative people, we do hold that responsibility to be morally right. We do hold that responsibility about things. I think so. Good makers, they have this sense of a very right moral responsibility and of not crossing that border. Of course, we do have censors for it. But I think we do also owe a lot of responsibility, because a film, when it is watched in theaters, from 14 to 80, 90, that is the age group. And the films definitely has a very, very strong influence on people. I very genuinely feel that. And that moral responsibility is on the maker. So we can't shirk away that responsibility.
Okay.
I think I should apologize for putting you in a spot, but I think that this was an important question. And as a film student, as a up and coming aspirer, let's say, of films, I'm interested in this. How do we influence minds of people? Yeah.
So with that, one more question that immediately struck my mind. We have heard a lot about art cinema, commercial cinema, and there is always a debate onto it. And honestly speaking, I have not been able to, you know, myself understand what exactly the difference is. So how do you look at this parallel or out art cinema, and you know, which one is your favorite?
So let me put this way. This session, I think so these students have come, and I feel this age group is the toughest to connect, because their attention span is so less. Few lines here and there, few boring moments, and they are not going to be with me. So this is the reason why I actually come to colleges to speak and be around kids and students, because to hold them, I mean, to hold you guys, it is the toughest. So let it put this way, that after this speech, if they feel bored, then it's an art film. If after this speech, if they entertain, engage, and there's some messaging they take back home, then it's a commercial film.
Okay. That's a great way to answer. I think we have got the crux.
So you touched one of my favorite nerves right now. Attention span of this generation, of my generation, I should say. This growth of OTT platforms and this growth and expansion of watch time. Look, earlier, people used to go to theater, 2.5 ghante ki, 3 ghante ki picture dekh ke bahar nikal jate the. Point was made. Ab, sir, I feel like this has become a hardcore business where the watch time has increased to like days and weeks and months, and people just binge on series. Point A ki banta hai, but how do you take the growth of this platform? And
I think that's going to be challenging for everyone. I think a lot of people must be into social media also, doing business on Insta stories, Twitter handles, creating news stories, making short films. A lot of people here I know are short film aspirants also. I think the first thing in today's generation a challenge is how to engage people, how not to miss them. People are watching web series by fast forwarding these days. I mean, in seconds they are taking this judgment ki acha ye to bakwas hai, ye nahi chalne wala. So in this today's generation, and probably this is something you will not learn in any film school or any media institute or whatever art form eventually you will end up being, how are you going to hold your audience? Even making a great poster, something which holds, you know, something which holds your attention, something, there's something about something which is unique, because messaging to baad mein aata hai na, pehle to entertainment aur engagement hai. So I think the same Raju Hirani rule, that entertain them so much, engage them so much, then once they are, the audience is with you, then give the message like a tonic, you know, which they don't even come to know. And that thing, so that's probably the right way of going, but it is only going to get challenging now, from now.
So after attending a film appreciation course that I did by Aruna Raja Patil, she's herself a 5-time National Award winner, director, editor. So it was her words that those who chose to become directors have this speck of madness in them, like a good kind of madness. So what do you think is that functional role of a director? What kind of a director are you, a collaborator or an executor? How do you prefer to be a part of your film?
So how many of you here wants to, I mean, I know it's little early to ask now. You must be about 17, 18 now. How many of you marginally feel that, okay, maybe I want to do films, you know? Okay, there are a few. Eventually, maybe you might. So, I think as a creator, now I'm not talking just in context of a filmmaker. I think so as a creator, the only thing which I feel is that curiosity in things, you know, and that is something which also lets you go, and curiosity in things, curiosity in everything you do, curiosity in traveling or curiosity in people or curiosity in traveling new cities. Because the moment you get settled, the moment you feel ki haan theek hai mereko aa gaya hai yaar ye mereko aata hai, that's where the wrong things start happening. I think the fact that we gotta be learning every day, the fact that you feel unsettled, you feel nervous. In fact, I was, after so many also, I was nervous of giving a speech here or talking, because I didn't know how the audience is going to be, what state of mind you are. It is your induction program. I think you're just going to start your college. That unsettling feeling, I think, is what something I look forward to. I try to, and I make sure it's there, because the day I become settled, the day I don't feel scared of things, the day I feel complacent, I think so that's going to be end of day.
Sir, one more question from my side. There's a lot of importance being given to post-production, that is promotions. It wasn't existing during the 70s, 80s and 90s films. But abhi abhi, if you see, ki movies karne ke baad, actors go to every city to promote their films. There's a lot of marketing that is involved into it. Sir, because you are also a director, how much importance do you give to this marketing, and how is that it has changed the entire production, the way the production has functioned? Marketing, marketing everywhere nowadays.
I think so. That has probably become important in every aspect of it. That's the reason we have so many agencies here. I mean, to sell anything, forget just films, you know, to film, to sell a FMCG product or real estate scheme, I think marketing or getting attention has become a key element. Of course, this is regardless of the fact that product has to be good, but just making a good product probably will not assure that it will sell. So, because there are so many options, I mean, today on a Friday evening, people have so many options. I mean, you go for traveling, you go for trekking, we have 1,000 channels, there are so many web series, and how do you make your film stand out? And that was probably not that tricky or challenging 10 years back. Probably we had lesser options of entertainment. Now these guys have so many options of entertainment. Or in attention span to 3 second hi hai. Matlab 3 second ek joke pasand nahi aaya to change kar denge. Abhi to main stage pe khada hu nahi to agar ye stage nahi to mujhe bhi swipe kar lete hain ki boring baatein kar raha hai. So that is the attention span. So it is a tricky situation, because just a good maker probably is just not good enough, and that's the reason.
So along the same lines, this amount of reliance on marketing, do you think this is a healthy approach? Do you think this is a solution? Do you think this will help good cinema to grow? Like when I went to watch Nandita Das's Manto, the whole theater was empty. I was actually scared while I was watching the film, because the film itself had Manto story, so what can we expect? But do you think this marketing and to publicize cinema is a solution or a pathway to bring in good cinema? Or are we lacking to make people aware about that there are directors and there are filmmakers who are making films that are worth a watch?
You know what's our nightmare? Our nightmare is ki mari film shukravare savare release thai ane film jova koi nathi aayu. ये हमारे लिए सबसे ख़राब सपना है और ये हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि ये सपना कभी भी सच ना हो. बिकॉज ईयर्स एंड ईयर्स ऑफ हार्डवर्क एंड हार्डवर्क ऑफ सो मेनी पीपल गोज इनटू मेकिंग फिल्म. 300-400 लोगों की मेहनत लगती है एंड रादर एंड इनफैक्ट मोर देन यू फील बैड फॉर देमसेल्फ. 200-300 लोगों ने आपको अपने साल अपने जिंदगी के 1.5 साल दिए हैं बिलीविंग यू. अच्छा ठीक है आप बोल रहे हो तो हम कर रहे हैं सर क्योंकि स्क्रिप्ट अच्छी लग रही है क्योंकि आपने हमको कन्विंस किया है. सो व्हेन अ फिल्म डजंट डू वेल इट डेफिनेटली इज वेरी डिमोरलाइजिंग. इट ब्रिंग्स अ वेरी आई मीन द टीम डेफिनेटली गेट्स स्कैटर्ड एंड फ्रॉम इकोनॉमिकल बैकग्राउंड ऑल्सो फ्रॉम इकोनॉमिक्स लाइक अ फिल्म विच डज वेल इट डेफिनेटली ब्रिंग्स अ लॉट ऑफ मनी लाइक अ रोहित शेट्टी फिल्म और अ बिग फिल्म. It brings a lot of finance to the industry and eventually it helps to make smaller films or experimental films. So I think so what you're asking is a sweet spot where a film which has a right messaging, it is entertaining, it is engaging, at the same time it has got the aesthetic right. I think that's a sweet spot we are all aiming for, but it doesn't happen. Most of the film which we watch, I don't want to name them, are the ones who have made money. They probably don't have any messaging and probably they don't contribute anything in terms of just sheer entertainment. And the films which are probably tremendously good in messaging, but people find them boring, they don't come to watch. So I think so as makers, how we tell the story is where the art is, you know. And I think good makers are the ones who tell that story in a way which is entertaining and engaging, and that's where the skill comes.
Sir, one question over here. A quick recall, jab Wrong Side Raju Friday ko release hone wali thi, Thursday night ko kya halat thi? Or let's say same with Made in China also. What are your emotions? What is the anxiety you would like to know?
Gujarati badan samjhaye chhe na? Badha na? Almost. So, Bhubu, honestly, kahu jo ki film release karta pehla, obviously we do a lot of focus group. એન્ડ ઘણા બધા લોકોને ઇન્ટરનલી બતાવી છે અને ફિલ્મ મેકર્સ કેટલું પણ પ્રોક્લેમ કરે એમને અંદરથી ખબર હોય છે કે અમે સારી પિક્ચર બનાવી ખરાબ બનાવી છે. તો ખરાબ પિક્ચર બનાવી હોય તો તમે ખાલી પ્રાર્થના કરો કે આ નીકળી જાય તો સારું, પણ અંદરથી ખબર હોય જ છે કે પિક્ચર સારી છે કે નહીં. એન્ડ ઇફ યુ ડોન્ટ નો ધીસ ધેન યુ શુડ નોટ મેક ફિલ્મ્સ, યુ નો. સો વી આર વેરી મચ સેલ્ફ અવેર ઓફ દેટ. Sometimes, yes, the judgment doesn't go so. Of course, a day before is full of nervousness because first 3 days is what that it sets the trend, you know. From distribution point of view also, if on a Sunday night, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, if you don't have more than 50% occupancy, however hard you try, you're not going to get shows. With my last film, of course, I'll share very honestly with you guys because it... Of course, we were aiming that it was a Diwali release with Made in China and we were aiming that it would probably do far, far better than what it has done now. I remember one incident which I'll share with you, which is very emotional also. Film ka third week chal raha tha aur film utni to nahi kar rahi thi jo hum soch rahe the. Also because it was a Diwali release and we had Houseful 4 and Sand Ki Aankh with us. Himalaya Mall mein थर्ड वीक का लास्ट शो देखने में गया था और सरप्राइजिंगली थिएटर पूरा भरा हुआ था पर एक ही स्क्रीन में लगी थी. दैट फीलिंग कि ये फिल्म कल से सब थिएटर में बंद हो रही है, दैट फीलिंग आई कैन नॉट फॉरगेट. इट इज़ सो इमोशनली ड्रेनिंग कि आपके सामने आपकी फिल्म उतर रही है, उस पर पर्दा लग रहा है और आपका कुछ नहीं कर सकते हो. दो पीपल आर लविंग इट एंड लाइकिंग इट बट इट्स नॉट इन योर हैंड्स. एंड इट वॉज दैट थर्सडे नाइट ऑफ थर्ड वीक एंड द फोर्थ वीक इट वॉज वैनिश फ्रॉम एवरीवेयर. There was no screen, even in Ahmedabad. So, it's in part and parcel of it, and we have to go through it. I mean, we can't hope and we can't feel that, we can't hope that every film will work, you know. There are going to be good ones and bad ones, and audience is very, very ruthless. they never fake. They're very honest. So yeah, it's a part of the puzzle of the journey.
It's really disheartening to see that. I really agree with you.
So about making a film and about knowing that you're making a good film, I want to know that as a filmmaker, when do you feel like you have created something that is good for you? Like that is, that this is, now I'm satisfied. When do you feel like that about your films?
I think we never feel that is in any job you do. On script schedule also you feel ki acha, I have cracked a great script now. But in fact, achhi film tabhi banti hai when every department of it is right, from your writing to your casting to your music. And that process for me especially is, and it's full of excitement, anxiety, nervousness, fulfilling, there are all sorts of feelings. But you never feel that, okay, we have made it, or, you know, till the time I think the audience, it reaches to audience and, you know, the reception.
Yeah.
So that feeling of nervousness is always there. And I feel the same for, while talking to you guys, I always feel that, because there are a lot of professors and teachers here, hats off to you guys, because this is the same audience to whom you take sessions for 60 minutes and 90 minutes. And in these times, it's so difficult every day to come prepared and teach them sometimes with boring subjects also, or boring chapters also. So I believe there are few professors here also.
Yes, yes. The first row is entire of faculty members.
So I think it's a very tough, I mean, I can't teach, I don't know, but it's definitely a very tough job. And I think you students should do a round of applause for your teachers and professors. I mean, you guys should be lucky that you have professors like Preeti. She's a stand-up comedian. I mean, I would have loved to have a teacher like these, with whom I could connect, I could joke, and of course, I could study also. So yeah.
So we would like to, so we all know that you have directed great actors, Boman Irani, you know, Paresh Rawalji, Rajkumar Rao, and many more, Gajraj Ji. So what has been your experience, you know, from the director's perspective? These are all veterans, they are all legends in their fields. So what has been your interaction, and any quick anecdotes or stories that you remember quickly that you would like to know more about?
Give you two very short stories. We knew when we were shooting and casting for Benin, we had Rajkumar and Baman, they are the best ones. But even for smaller roles, we wanted certain kind of actor. Big story, yeah. I don't know how many of you have seen the film. The character played by Paresh Rawal is a character called Tanmay Shah. Now the brief for that character was that we wanted someone Indian version of Warren Buffett, like a big businessman working out of India. Ani bhi story je ke aa character ne scene aayu kirite. I was traveling to Poland and mara baju ma ek Gujarati bhai beta tha, bahut smart. Bahu vaato kari ane પોલિટિક્સ વિશે વાત કરી, એમને ઇકોનોમી વિશે વાત કરી, અને બધી ઊંચી ઊંચી ફેંક એકદમ. અને પછી ફ્લાઇટ લેન્ડ થઈ, પછી એમને કીધું કે મેં તમારું નામ શું, ખબર પડી, અચ્છા તો ગુજરાતી છે ભાઈ, લાગે નહીં જરા પણ. અને અમુક એમને મને કીધું કે મારું નામ તન્મય છે, હિસ રિયલ નેમ હતો તન્મય. તો મેં ખાલી જતા હતા પૂછ્યું કે સાહેબ તમે કરો છો શું આમ, તમે બહુ જ જ્ઞાન આપ્યું મને. હિસ આન્સર વોઝ, ઇટ અમેઝ મી, કે વાળાવાળા બક્કલ ને બક્કલ, હું બક્કલ વેચું છું કે. સો બક્કલ વેચવાવાળો 50 કરોડ નું એમ્પાયર ચલાવે છે. એન્ડ દેટ વોઝ માય બ્રીફ. સેકન્ડલી, ઇવન ઇન ધ સેમ ટ્રીપ, આઈ વોઝ એકચ્યુઅલી વેઇટિંગ એટ અ હોટેલ લોબી એન્ડ આઈ મેટ અ વેરી ઇન્ટરેસ્ટિંગ ગાય, અગેન સુટેડ બુટેડ ગાય, એન્ડ હી ડિન્ટ સીમ ટુ બી ઇન્ડિયન. સો હી વોઝ આસ્કિંગ મી દેટ વોટ યુ ડુ, મેન આઈ મેક ફિલ્મ્સ. સો હી વોઝ આસ્કિંગ અબાઉટ ધ ઇન્ટરનેટ સિનારિયો એન્ડ ડિજિટલ સિનારિયો ઓફ ઇન્ડિયા, ક્યાં ચાલ રહ્યા. તો અમને તો મેં બહુ ઉસકો ધ્યાન દિયા કે સર અભી ઇન્ડિયા બહુ ડિજિટલી આગે કર રહા હૈ, હમ મેક ઇન ઇન્ડિયા કર રહે કર રહે. એસા 10-15 મિનિટ બોલા, વો હસ રહા થા, વો સુન રહા થા. વો ફિર મેને પૂછા કે આપ ક્યા કરતે હો, તો હી વોઝ ગૂગલ એશિયા પેસિફિક હેડ. સો ધ વોટ આઈ વોઝ એક્સપ્લેનિંગ હી વોઝ હેડિંગ ધ, વી વોઝ ઓલરેડી ડુઈંગ ઇટ. સો દીઝ એક્સપિરિયન્સિસ ઇનફેક્ટ, યુ નો, દે કમ ઇન ટુ યોર સ્ક્રિપ્ટ. એન્ડ માય બ્રીફ ટુ એકચ્યુઅલી પરેશ રાવલ વોઝ દીઝ સીન્સ દેટ આઈ વોન્ટ અ કેરેક્ટર આઉટ ઓફ ધીસ, એન્ડ હી ગોટ દેટ. And finally, he came on board.
I think that deserves a huge round of applause. So the characters that we usually see on silver screen, you've actually directed them. So it's a great.
In fact, one of the things which nobody, again, no film school will teach you, and you know, any school will teach you, is actually power of convincing someone. वॉट एवर यू डू इन लाइफ, इंटरव्यू के लिए जाओगे तो एक इंसान को भी तो कन्विंस करना है ना, वो बॉस को कन्विंस करना है कि मेरे को जॉब दे दो. आई थिंक सो द वंस हु नो हाउ टू टर्न द टेबल्स, द वंस हु हैव अ ग्रेट कन्विंसिंग पावर आर गोइंग टू गो वेरी अहेड इन लाइफ, बिकॉज दैट्स ऑल यू आर गोइंग टू डू प्रोफेशनली. यू एट एवरी सेकेंड यू आर सेलिंग योर सेल्फ एंड कन्विंसिंग समवन, बी इट इंटरव्यू, बी इट योर कस्टमर्स, बी इट योर क्लाइंट्स, बी इट योर बॉसेस, एंड try to get better at it, you know, if you're not. I think that's all, that is something which is going to be very much required. And because you guys are into media and studying this, eventually you will end up going in fields which are very people-centric, you know, which are not just account-based or IT-based. So there is going to be a lot of people interaction. So that's one of the reasons, and one of the things which I'd say every time, मैं अखा कॉलेज पर एक चौपड़ी नहीं वाँची, पर अत्यारे हूँ महीना नहीं एटलीस्ट 10 चौपड़ी वाँचू छू, बिकॉज ऑन अ वेरी लेटर पार्ट ऑफ माय लाइफ आई रियलाइज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ रीडिंग एंड वॉट इट डज टू यू. वाँचू के सारूँ जो पची मत पहला वो लगत कि ठीक है इंजीनियरिंग की चौपड़ी आटली जाड़ी जाड़ी नहीं पत्ती तो क्या वाँचवा नवी चौपड़ी, पर पची खबर पड़ी कि बॉस वाँची तो खबर पड़ से, अगर वाँची नहीं तो पची क्या थी नॉलेज आ. एंड सो वॉचिंग फिल्म्स, ट्रैवलिंग, मीटिंग डिफरेंट पीपल, very later I realized what these are the things I should invest and not waste my time on, which will we all do on Instagram. So yeah, that's what it is.
Thank you so much, sir. So your top 5 favorite directors, your personal favorite.
But top 5, of course, I Anurag Kashyap definitely, yes, because I'm not saying that he is one of the best directors. Everyone has a taste. I like the kind of films which he used to make also. One more director which I really I think has also changed, there's a director which is not very very known. How many of you know Shimit Amin, this professor? I think so, he's very enthusiastic, I think so, he's nodding at every, I'm a big cinema fan also, I must say. Shimit Amin a three film banayi je khali ab tak 56, रॉकेट सिंह और चक दे इंडिया.
यस,
चक दे इंडिया इनफैक्ट होपफुली एंड एज अ न्यूज बिकेम अ ट्रू न्यूज यस्टरडे.
यस,
व्हेन अ वुमेन्स इंडियन टीम दे एंटर्ड सेमीफाइनल्स, आई थिंक सो, नॉट फॉर अस बट लेट्स क्लैप फॉर देम फ्रॉम वेर एवर दे आर, इट्स सो अमेजिंग. आई डोंट नो इफ प्रीति इज हियर, द ओनली एंड ओनली women's team are winning so many medals and they are the ones, and I don't think so we now need any reasoning to even ponder or think that what actually women can do and what actually they are doing. And there's I mean, all of it is yet to, there's a lot of games still left. We hope that they get more and more medals. Coming back to the director question, so yes, we have one down. Second is Shimit Amin for the kind of films he's made. I don't know why he doesn't make more films. Third is Vishal Bharadwaj. Of course, I think what he's done with Kamine, Omkara, and how he's changed and got the structure of Shakespeare and the kind of films he has made. He is definitely number 3. I'm saying Indian names because, you know, they would know better. If they don't know Shimit Amin, they wouldn't know. Christopher Nolan, of course, I think so. I mean, I believe a lot of fans would be here, you know. All science fanboys of the kind of films he's made. And हम भी makers, हम भी audience ही यार, मतलब जो लोगों को पसंद है हमको भी पसंद आता है. ऐसा तो नहीं है कि मतलब मैं फ्रेंच सिनेमा देखता हूँ, इधर आके गुजराती बनाता हूँ. मैं भी वही देखता हूँ. आई जस्ट नाउ ट्राई टू गेट बेटर स्टोरीज, मीट मोर इंटरेस्टिंग पीपल, एंड इट हेल्प्स अस टू गेट द स्टोरीज, यू नो. एंड द फिफ्थ नेम, I think I am a big fan of Nagaraj Manjule also. Everybody must have watched Sairat, but I don't think so. You guys would have seen Fandry. There's a film called Fandry, which is again a national award-winning film. Please watch. So I'm not also saying that ki only watch very meaningful cinema, but if you're watching 10 films, make sure at least 3 or 4 you watch which has some right messaging or which has something to say, you know. Entertainment acha hai. सबको एंटरटेनमेंट अच्छा लगता है, पर एंटरटेनमेंट के साथ अगर कुछ सीख रहे हैं, कुछ ज्ञान आ रहा है, तो वो वेस्ट नहीं जाएगा, काम ही आएगा, यू नो. एंड बिलीव मी इफ एट ऑल यू आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड हियर टू स्पीक समडे इफ यू आर नॉट रेड और लिसन एंड स्पोक एंड टॉक टू पीपल यू वोंट बी एबल टू स्पीक फॉर मोर देन 10 मिनट्स विच आई रियलाइज ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी रिसेंटली सो इट्स इन द सेल्फिश इंटरेस्ट ऑफ एवरी वन टू रीड एंड लिसन एंड टू बी सराउंडेड विथ इंटरेस्टिंग एंड पीपल विच यू गेट टू लर्न सो दैट हैज बीन माई लेसन
About this film, I probably know your answer to this, but I'll still ask. The White Tiger, it had a very similar kind of plot to Wrong Side Raju. What was your reaction? Were you bothered like it getting nominated for Best Screenplay in Oscars? And what was your reaction? I just want to know that.
Interesting question. You should also become a film critic. In fact, you have a good prospect. So, I think yes. In fact. White Tiger बुक कितने लोगों ने पढ़ी है बॉस यू गाइस शुड रीड बुक्स आई मीन इट रियली हेल्प्स सो या सो इनफैक्ट White Tiger आई वॉज चेजिंग द राइट्स ऑफ White Tiger फॉर वेरी वेरी लॉन्ग आई थिंक इट्स अरविंद अडिगा's सेकेंड और थर्ड बुक इट्स वन ऑफ द मोस्ट वेल रिटन एंगेजिंग बुक I've ever रेड Of course, Arvind was a bookseller that time, and he didn't respond. So, बहुत साल चले गए. फिर Wrong Side Raju हमने बनाई. उसके बाद definitely White Tiger का trailer आया. I personally speaking was expecting a much much better film compared to the book, and the messaging in the story in the book is excellent. But when I watched the film, I think. Probably the similarities except the hit and run accident and the socio economic class system which we both are trying to show in the film there was no similarity
so do you think the star aspect and the fact that it was written by someone not belonging to India or maybe say it was released by Netflix and publicized all the more do you think it did you feel bad about it like
Good and bad both. In fact, for foreign filmmakers, I have a perspective. In fact, lot of, and this, you guys also must have noticed this, lot of photographers outside India, they big, many times, they click better pictures than Indian ones. Because they have a different perspective. आप riverfront रोज देख रहे हो पर जो इंसान बाहरेन से आया है वो riverfront को बहुत अलग तरीके से देख रहा है और इसके लिए उसका perspective बहुत interesting होता है Like what Danny Boyle brought perspective of Bombay in Slumdog Millionaire was very different than the perspective we had seen before through Indian makers. I think so what the director, he was a Bahrain director, what perspective he brought on this Indian boy's story probably had good and bad parts both, which we all know now. Definitely the perspective was very, very different. Maybe personally the film didn't click to me on other levels, but when people from different nations or people like and in fact anyone who doesn't belong to that territory when he goes there tries to write or click a picture his perspective is going to be very different than someone who is a local there which is a little unpopular opinion people log bolte hain ki aap aapki jagah ki kahani hai batao agar aap kota ho to kota ki kahani likho theek hai बट जो लोग बाहर से आते हैं वो कोटा को बहुत अलग तरीके से देखेंगे और जो लोग बाहर से आते हैं वो लोग गुजरात को बहुत अलग तरीके से देखेंगे एंड दैट पर्सपेक्टिव इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग लास्ट 5 मिनट्स
या सर आई जस्ट हैव वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम माय साइड सो व्हेन आई काइंड ऑफ लुक फॉर स्टोरीज और मे बी व्हेन आई राइट when I start thinking about it too much, I start to feel like ये तो कोई भी लिख सकता है या ये इतनी खास नहीं है this is not something new or original. How do you maintain that confidence in your project? Like, does it ever get कि it might not work and how do you still manage to work throughout the film for like 1 year, 2 year? How does that go?
So we have a process. Boss, we have to run through people. We have to test run. Or this is a thing which I tell to everyone, even if it's a startup idea or a restaurant you want to start. आजकल बहुत चालू है ना इडली डोसा क्या है खोल दिया उन्होंने अरे कहीं पर करो जो why not to test into people? When we are writing a script, on an average, we at least narrate to 70 to 80 people, 100 people, and from everyone, from our drivers to office boy to the CEOs, even those people who don't understand Hindi.
Secretly.
And in that process, I think दूध का दूध पानी का पानी हो जाता है मतलब इफ 80% ऑफ देम आर नॉट लाइकिंग अ स्क्रिप्ट देट देर वेरी गुड चांसेस दैट इट विल नॉट वर्क एंड वाइस वर्सा. So that has been my journey and my experience, and that's what we do. That's what we have learned from our mentors to do. Preeti, what do you think about it? I called your name so many times, but you were not around, you know. Okay. I hope I have answered your question.
Yeah. So the students, the forum is open for you. If anybody can ask a question, would like to ask a question, I think we have somebody who is from the cinema. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, this is Kanishk. Sir, as a writer and director, it's a perspective of a writer ki jaisi humne film sochi hai, jaisi humne film likhi hai, waisi hi screen pe dikhe. So this is the task of a video editor. The main task is of video editor, but right now demand zyada hai, supply kam hai, and also jitne bhi common public hai, they think ki video yun banta hai. So what are your views on the responsibilities and attributions of video editor in a film?
So in fact, to decode your question, your first part of the question was more interesting, that ki jo sochte waisa banta hai kya. I think films or videos, whatever, teen stages pe banti hai, while writing, while shooting, and while editing. These are the three phases where you have a chance to improve the craft. Ek bar likh lete hain, उसके बाद शूट के ऊपर तुम एक्टर्स के थ्रू ऐसा एक्टिंग करवाओ कि खराब सीन भी अच्छा लगे, और उसके बाद एडिट के ऊपर. एडिट इज अ वेरी अंडररेटेड प्रोसेस. एडिट के ऊपर कुछ भी कर सकते हो. बहुत खराब फिल्में भी अच्छी बनी एडिट पे, और बहुत अच्छी फिल्में भी बहुत खराब हुई है, वी ऑल नो. सो दीज आर ओनली थ्री स्टेजेस. ये तीन स्टेज के बाद कोई चांस नहीं है. फिर तुम्हारा नाम गणेश है तो ऊपर भगवान ही बचाएगा, तो फिर भगवान ही बचा सकता है अगर ये तीन स्टेजेस के ऊपर भी इफ योर कॉन्टेंट डजंट कम आउट.
There is one more student who wanted to ask a question. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon. Is it working? Okay, so I wanted to ask you one thing, that what matters the most if we see from earning perspective? Like star cast or content? Because we have seen that Trace 3 has done really good amount if we compare to Newton. So what is your point of view if we see this?
Between content and star cast, sorry, I didn't get the question answered.
Like what matters the most if we see from earning perspective, that obviously everyone want to earn. So what is the main thing, like star cast or content? Because we have seen that Trace
3... I think I'll give you the answer. Bahut hi brief mein answer deta hu ki star or content karta kya hai. आज के ज़माने में विदाउट कॉन्टेंट यू कैंट सर्वाइव एनी आइडिया, नॉट जस्ट फिल्म्स, एनीथिंग. बिकॉज पीपल हैव बिकम वेरी इंटेलिजेंट, दे नो वॉट इज गुड वॉट इज बैड, दे वुडेंट स्टैंड अ बैड फिल्म इवन फॉर अ सेकेंड. बट वॉट स्टार्स डज इज दैट अ गुड स्टार, ही गिव्स यू फर्स्ट थ्री डेज. वेन रणवीर सिंह एक्ट्स इन अ फिल्म, वो आपको 35 करोड़ का वीकेंड देता है, फिर मंडे से कॉन्टेंट है. तो स्टार्स पहला 3 दिन देते हैं, कॉन्टेंट लाइफ टाइम देता है. If any of that is not there, then you compromise on it.
Okay, possibly we can take the last question now, as we are running short of time. So, so please pass on the mic to this person.
That guy is raising since the beginning. You want to ask? It is audible. Samrat sir, you can. Sorry.
It's not audible. You can come forward. Quickly.
Hello.
Yeah, please.
Okay. Sir, when we talked about the misogyny part, Kabir Singh ka jo tha, sir, that was basically the controversy was around ki wo toxic masculinity par zyada focused tha, wo controversy pura. But sir, we have seen in Bollywood.
Hold the mic little closer to your.
We have seen in Bollywood many item songs which objectify women. Kabhi Coca-Cola bol diya, chocolate bol diya even. So sir, us songs mein we all have vibe to those songs many a times in parties, in family gatherings as well. So sir, why do you think ki sirf ek wo movie ka jo part tha us par hi controversy hua? Both these things shows,
which film?
Kabir Singh.
Okay.
Uska jo controversy tha pura. सो दोनों ही टॉक्सिक मस्कुलिनिटी पर था, जो आइटम सॉन्ग्स है दे ऑब्जेक्टिफाई वुमेन टू अ ग्रेट एक्सटेंट, राइट। और इस पर भी ऐसा ही था कि सर टॉक्सिक मस्कुलिनिटी दिखा रहे थे। सो व्हाई डू थिंक कबीर सिंह के उस मूवी पर ही कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी हुआ एंड नॉट द अदर बॉलीवुड आइटम सॉन्ग्स की जो हम रोज सुनते हैं एंड वी वाइब टू दोस सॉन्ग्स एज वेल।
व्हाट्स योर नेम?
ध्याय।
वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन। It's a tough one. See, to be very honest, Kabir Singh worked,
yes.
And it was seen also, and it entertained also, and that's where the problem began also. If Kabir Singh wouldn't have been watched or entertained us, हम ये discuss ही नहीं करते। ऐसी बहुत सारी फिल्में आई हैं which has been very misogynist and it has emitted toxicity, male toxicity like anything, but maybe we have not seen those films. I think this the answer is little complex. However, this male toxicity, misogyny, it all has to stop, either through item songs or probably writing one-sided characters, one-note women characters, characters of women just probably are there to basically as a supporting element to the main protagonist. Times are changing, and people are realizing that fact. But also the fact that my earlier theory that Kabir Singh actually for more than 50% was actually watched by mid-age women. So that's the most ironical part, that they are the ones who in fact liked also. So we are of course walking on borderline. It is a very borderline issue where what is correct or what's not correct. But I do get that as makers, we need to understand that these item song, this objectifying, all this using these kind of words just for getting better hits or better views, it has to stop. It has to stop right now, you know. It is the end of the hour.
So what you're saying is it depends on audience how they take the movie, or because bahut sare directors they make these movies and they work.
I mean, see, it's an eventual thing. It is symbiotic also. I mean, if we make more films like that, then there is always going to be audience. But as makers also, we need to be very, very self-aware. There is a moral responsibility towards it. There is a censor to it. But I think so we need to understand that moral responsibility and that type of entertainment that needs to be discouraged, you know. And only with times and if we stop doing and making those kind of songs, then only people will, because if you don't know, there is good content otherwise, like when we are watching Family Man or when we are watching, we realize that ki achhi kahaniyan bhi achhi tarike se bol sakte hain. You don't need these things or songs, you know, to promote. So it needs to be stopped.